approaching author burnout in 3, 2. So one of the things I've done sort of inadvertently over the years of vlogging is talk about the things that maybe aren't as amazing about being a published author. Now, of course, under the great umbrella of life, all of these things are amazing. We are all lucky, all of us authors who are published or about to be published, we all know we're lucky. So please don't think that I'm sort of complaining about being prom queen, as I'd like to say. But there are certain parts of being a published author that are maybe not as pleasant all the time. I've talked about the pressures of writing to deadline, and I've talked about what it means to be a mid-list author at a big publisher. And this time I'm going to talk about the demands on your time for public appearances. All of the events listed at the beginning of this vlog are events that I either have done or am scheduled to do. All of them between the time that 10 came out on September 18th and the week before Christmas, which will be my last events of the year. So essentially in 3 months, I will have done all of those things. Most of them are weekends because up until last week, of course, I worked full time. Some of them were weeknights. Some of them required me to take time off of work and travel. But essentially, other than Thanksgiving weekend, during which I have no events planned, I have not had a single weekend off from doing book events since 10 came out in mid-September. Now, one of the great things about being an author is being able to get in front of readers and fans. There is sort of no greater thrill for us to actually be able to talk to the people that we write books for, which is you guys. I guess some writers will tell you that they write for themselves. I totally get that. But clearly I write books to be consumed and enjoyed by the readers. And so I like nothing more than when someone says to me, "Oh my God, I love 10, I couldn't put it down." And the first question I always ask is, "Did you guess who did it?" Because I really do want to know. And that is an amazing perk. I think there's very few industries where the celebrities are as approachable as authors are, especially in the YA community. You can come out to any event where we are and come up and talk to us and take photos with us and ask us questions. And 99.9% of the time, we are all happy and excited to answer them and interact with you. The problem, though, is especially around the time that your book comes out or in the fall, which is a really busy time for book tours and things, you start lining up these events back to back to back. I've had 2 book events a day. I've had 3 in a weekend. And it gets a little tiring, exhausting, soul-sucking sometimes. You know, every once in a while you do that event where like 3 people show up and you know 2 of them. So, I try really, really hard not to let the fatigue show. I want the readers who come for every event that I do or that I'm a part of to feel that I'm excited to be there and that my energy is good. But it's hard sometimes. I'm not going to lie to you. It's hard to constantly be on like that. The fallout of doing a lot of events, especially in such a short amount of time, is that something has to give. I call it the rule of 2s, which is I can basically be 2 things at the same time. And in my world right now, there are sort of 4 things that are vying for one of those 2 slots. There's employee Gretchen, part-time now, but it's still taking up more of my time than I thought it would. There's friend and girlfriend Gretchen. There is Gretchen the writer, who has deadlines. And there's Gretchen the author, who has certain demands on her time for public events and guest posts and things of that nature. I can only do 2 at a time. And I think you can tell by the boxes sitting here that are still unpacked from my boyfriend's recent move-in, that certain things are falling by the wayside. And basically what that means is in coming months, I'm going to have to say no to certain things like events and guest posts and things like that because I just won't have the time. And until I either hire an intern or figure out a way to clone myself, that's just the way it's going to be. totally spilled on my chest. That was awesome.